My coverage of Computex 2024 is brought to you by ASUS, Antec, Thermaltake, and Fractal. Welcome everyone to our second video for Computex 2024. I'm going to be recapping AMD's just made big announcements at their Computex keynote. And since it is absolutely raining buckets outside, I'm reporting from our couch at our Airbnb. AMD announced some new CPUs and some more new CPUs.
Excellent!
Unfortunately, as expected, we didn't hear much from the Radeon side of things. AMD's focus here at Computex is on two things: their new Zen 5 CPU microarchitecture, which is a brand new design, as well as their new XDNA 2 AI NPU architecture, which is also somewhat new, but also a little bit more nebulous. So let's start with the hard facts that we have on the desktop products that were announced. AMD's new Ryzen 9000 series of desktop processors, which will slot into existing AM5 motherboards with a BIOS update, but there will be new X870 and X870E chipset motherboards too. So let's start at the top of the Ryzen 9000 series stack with the new 9950X, 16 cores and 32 threads. And by the way, all of these CPUs were previously known as codenamed Granite Ridge. If you've been watching my tech news series up till now, we've been discussing these quite a bit, so it's good to finally have confirmation. Now, if you're comparing the 9950X specs to the 7950X, you're gonna see a lot of similarities here. They're both 16 cores, 32 threads, 5.7 gigahertz boost clock, 80 megabytes of total cache, that's 16 megs L2, 64 megs L3. And beyond that, we're maintaining socket AM5 support, PCI Express Gen 5 support, and DDR5 support. The main difference here is going to be that microarchitecture change, upgrading to Zen 5. And that's gonna be the big question that reviewers need to help answer next month, sometime in July when these actually launch. Is how much of a performance improvement AMD has gained just from their new microprocessor architecture. AMD did share some of their performance numbers that I'm gonna cover in just a moment, but let's continue our run down the stack. Next, we have the Ryzen 9 9900X. That's a 12-core, 24-thread model, the successor to the 7900X. 5.6 gigahertz max boost, 76 megs of cache. These are pretty much against the same specs as the 7900X, but do note that the TDP is 120 watts. That is down from 170 watts with the standard 7900X, but it is the same as the 7900X3D, which also came in at 120 watts. My impression of the 12-core 7900X was always that it had a little bit of middle child syndrome. It wasn't quite as popular as the top-end chip with 16 cores, or the 7800X3D, of course, which is a much better choice for gaming. But with that drop in TDP and the focus on efficiency for this generation, AMD seems to be pitching this more as a combination of performance and efficiency with 12 cores, but probably not going to be as focused on gaming this time around. So it seems a bit more like they're aiming for a sweet spot between performance and efficiency with the 9900X, and we'll see if that impacts sales at all. This one probably isn't going to be quite as good for gaming though. Next up in the four CPU lineup is the 9700X. This is the 8-core 16-thread model with a 5.5 gigahertz boost, 40 megs of shared cache, and this has a 65-watt TDP, so like the 9900X, that is a bit down from previous generation 8 cores with the 7000 series. 7800X3D was 120 watts, 7700X was 105 watts. The standard Ryzen 7700 without an X or a 3D was also 65 watts, but we'll see how much of a performance improvement the 9700X can provide versus that chip at the same TDP. Finally, we have the 9600X, 6 cores, 12 threads, 5.4 gigahertz boost, 38 megs of shared cache, 65-watt TDP, which is again a drop versus the previous generation. The 7600X had a 105-watt TDP. So AMD is clearly highlighting the efficiency gains that they have made with the Zen 5 microarchitecture, and hopefully that will be balanced out with performance improvements at the same time. Let's take a quick look at some of the performance numbers that AMD shared. This is sort of a delicate balancing act that AMD does. We can't always directly trust these numbers, but at the same time, AMD doesn't want to overpromise too much by cherry-picking apps or games that their CPUs overperform at, so that when the reviews come out, they say AMD was completely off with their estimation with this performance. Basically, what I'm saying is take these numbers with a grain of salt and wait for the independent reviews next month to actually verify. Certain claims like up to 2x, and they put a big 2x in the middle of the screen, is specifically referring to stuff that isn't going to impact your actual CPU, compute, or gaming performance much. Like twice the instruction and data bandwidth and twice the AI performance supposedly is just a reason for them to put a big 2x on the screen. The next slide is slightly more reasonable. They're claiming that Zen 5 has a 16% IPC uplift for PCs. This is the geo mean across a variety of both compute and gaming tasks that AMD selected. But check out that footnote at the very bottom, asterisk, all results are up to So we're seeing up to 16% IPC uplift, not on average, which of course means that your mileage may vary if you upgrade to this CPU depending on the application that you're using. Of course, if you're planning on running one of these apps or playing one of these games that they're specifically listing, I would have some degree of trust that these numbers are not too far off reality. AMD also put up a 9950X versus 14900K comparison. Intel has been struggling a bit lately, and they do need to come up with something special for their new CPUs that are supposed to still launch later this year. But versus the 14900K, and again, these are AMD's numbers, grain of salt, but they did a range of productivity and content creation tasks, as well as gaming tasks, and these were their results. And that is pretty much all they shared about the new Ryzen 9000 series processors, although we do expect a few more tidbits to trickle out as the week progresses. But what about those other things that AMD talked about? Let's quickly cover those. We have the new Ryzen AI 300 series of processors. Are they APUs? Are they mobile CPUs? They're mobile CPUs, basically, but AMD didn't specifically use that terminology. You're first probably going to see these in a series of thin and light laptops that launch also around the July timeframe. That is the rough estimate we've been given for these processors. There are two of them specifically that they announced, and it gets a little confusing because AMD has basically completely shuffled around and redone their naming scheme. I'm always a little bit baffled when they do something like this, but AMD is clearly trying to make these processors stand apart from their existing processors or CPUs that don't have some level of AI acceleration integrated, because that is really what their focus is here. How can we put AI into the processor? How can we put AI into the chip name? And as they very specifically said in their press briefing, it's so when people go to somewhere like Best Buy and they're like, I want a new laptop. I've heard about this AI stuff. Ooh, that one says AI on it. Let's get that one. Thankfully, AMD did put up a slide explaining their new branding for third gen Ryzen AI. They took the word AI and they put it there in between Ryzen and the 9 or the 7 or whichever tier of product it's going to be. They took the X, and instead of having the X at the end of the final number, they pulled it back and put it next to an H. That is apparently the brand level. Does that include the 9 or not? I'm not sure. This line doesn't exactly begin and end where these actual numbers do. Like the series here, is that referring to the 3 or the 7? The SKU number is a 70, but there's also going to be maybe like a 5 in there because we do have two SKUs that were presented to us. We have the Ryzen AI 9 HX 370, and we have the Ryzen AI 9 365, which doesn't have an H or an X. So if you really don't like H's or X's, I guess that's the one you should go for. As AMD was explaining this to us with the slide there and saying, this is how we made it really easy, all I could think of was no, AMD, you're not making this really easy. I think you've done this. You've taken the Ryzen branding, which has been progressing for years and years since it was first launched in 2016, which has an established market presence, and people have some level of understanding, if they have investigated CPUs at all, what those various parts of the product title mean. But what AMD is trying to do here is put AI up front for people shopping at Best Buy who don't know any better, and assuming that those people have some previous existing knowledge of your product SKU naming system that is very simple now because you've just taken this element and moved it here and moved this over here, it just seems to make things more confusing for me rather than less. But maybe that's the real intent. Make the product name all confusing so that all they see is AI, and then they say, I want AI, so let's pay more money for that one. Unfortunately, benchmarking of AI-specific tasks is still like really confusing right now. There's just so many of them, and the industry hasn't really come together to agree upon, like, here's how we can actually test and judge the performance of this new part of a CPU that you're integrating along with the CPU and the integrated GPU. We now have the NPU, or neural processing unit. So again, AMD shared a handful of benchmarks about how their AI NPU can improve things, but I'm not going to focus on that too much because I think we're still in the infancy of testing actual performance for NPUs. I did want to call out two more things for the AI CPUs, though. One is that they're using a mix of cores. It's a combination of Zen 5 and Zen 5C cores. And then the other is that the integrated graphics are based on RDNA 3.5. A couple other things to mention before we wrap up. One is AMD did give a shout out to their unmatched socket longevity. And here is an area I actually agree with them. I really appreciate that AM4 had such a long lifespan, and there's actually a couple new CPUs for that platform as well. And we really hope that they extend that commitment with AM5 as well, because it's been a great feature for people who invest in AMD's platform and then want to maybe upgrade a CPU down the line. You don't need to completely rebuild your system. Of course, they immediately followed that with, and we also have new chipsets for new motherboards. boards. There's X870 and X870E, which presumably is going to be the same type of configuration that they have for their 600 series motherboards. X870 will have one of the chips, and X870E will have two of the chips for additional I/O. That has not been confirmed. That's speculation on my part, though. I will be visiting some motherboard manufacturers on this trip, so I'll try to get some shots of some new X870 and X870E motherboards to share with you guys as my coverage continues. Beyond that, for X870, we have USB 4.0 as a standard, PCI Express Gen 5 for both the GPU and the NVMe SSD on both chipsets, and they say that these motherboards will support higher Expo memory clocks, which also probably means that they're going to be better suited for high-end memory overclocking as well. And lastly, we have a couple new AM4 CPUs for the socket and platform that just won't die, the Ryzen 9 5900 XT and Ryzen 7 5800 XT. And while I have previously stated that I really appreciate the AM4 socket longevity and everything, I'm starting to get to the point where, like, AMD, we have enough AM4 CPUs. My feeling is that they probably have extra Zen 4 dies that they've been binning out that didn't necessarily fit with their existing SKUs. They've collected those and dropped them into these. The 5800 XT is gonna have a higher frequency, up to 4.8 gigahertz. Max boost. It's going to have a Wraith Prism cooler with RGB LEDs, which probably isn't a selling point for many people. Notably, even though the 5900 XT is named 5900 XT, it's not a 12 core though, it's 16 cores and 32 threads, also with a higher frequency of 4.8 gigahertz. I have a feeling that gamers and new builders probably aren't gonna see too much value in these CPUs. They're probably gonna be looking more towards building on Zen 5, but it does mean there are more options for anyone who is building or upgrading an AM4 system. Those should also be coming in July 2024. AMD did initially include prices for them, but then they said actually, hold off on that, we'll let you know later. So we'll let you know what the prices are. We don't know the prices of the 9000 series CPUs either. Now, since I'm pre-recording this, if there's any additional information that comes out in the keynote when it goes live, I'm gonna add a comment to the comment section down below. And that's just if there's anything significant that comes up that wasn't included in the press briefing. But just some closing thoughts and analysis, some notes I wrote down as I was going over the press briefing. They have not announced or even confirmed any X3D parts yet for the Ryzen 9000 series. So that's a little disappointing for gamers. If you're specifically focused on gaming, there's a good chance that there will be X3D CPUs that launch at some points. And since the X3D 5000 and 7000 series CPUs have a significant boost in gaming performance, gamers are probably going to want to hold out for those. Also on the X3D side of things, I'm very curious to know in terms of gaming specifically, the 9950X and the 9700X are probably gonna be the most sought after CPUs, I'm guessing, for this generation. Maybe the 9600X as well, depending on how competitively priced it is. But how will these CPUs, without the aid of 3D V-Cache, perform against the 7800X 3D? Is there a chance that they might perform worse than the previous gen processor with the aid of 3D V-Cache? I'd say there's a decent likelihood of that, but again, it's gonna greatly depend on how much performance improvement AMD has gotten out of their new Zen 5 architecture. I already talked about pricing. I already talked about these are expected to launch in July. The specific date is TBD. The only other thing I wrote here is that dumb branding works, and that slapping AI onto these new processors they have with the NPUs integrated is probably going to work, despite how frustrating and annoying it is for certain of us who would prefer that AMD and other brands stick to a naming scheme that's a little bit more accessible and a little bit more understandable. But that is gonna wrap it up for this video, you guys. I wanna say a big thank you to my sponsors for Computex 2024, Asus, Fractal, Thermaltik, and Antec. I have lots more videos coming at you real soon, so hit the thumbs up button, subscribe if you're not already, check out the playlist, it should be linked in the description if you wanna see all my Computex coverage. A big thank you to Joe for heading to Taiwan with me, and we'll see you all in the next video.